Hello friends, my name is Jitender Bapna. Today I will going to show you how you can connect box storage using MuleSoft. So basically box provide the connector which you can use to connect the box storage. So to connect the box, we require OAuth. So to get authenticated to box, we have to use the OAuth authorization code. So authorization code is nothing, it's a grant type. Okay, I will show you one demo where I will try to create a folder into the box. So let me show you. So this is my box. So like app.box.com, you can create your account in the box. It give 5 GB of data free. So these are the folder. I will try to create one or two folders here. Then apart from that, like this is box developer where like you can create your client ID and the client secret which you require for authentication purpose. And these are the list of API which is available. So for OAuthorization, we require API. We require request access token API. Okay, and then like I want. I haven't copied properly. This is my token API, and last. The folders API, I want to create a folders. Okay, so you can find it here somewhere here. This is my folder API. Copy this, not folder ID. Let me search it again. Post a create folder. It's a copy folder. I don't want copy folder. I want create folder. Yeah. I don't understand where I'm. Yeah, this is the right API. Okay, so first we need to create an application in the box. So how you can do it? So for getting the client ID and client secret, you create on create new application, custom application. Next, you select standard OAuth 2.0 and give the unique name to application. Okay, whatever, like don't give this name, MuleSoft test app. Okay, and create app. Once you create the app, it will give you, client ID and client secret. I will not going to create it again. So I already have many apps. So I will close it and I will use this test app. Okay, and in test app, I will go to configuration. So one thing you need to make sure, like your callback URL must be, callback URL is very important. And like it needs to be registered with your box application, what application we have created, and it should be same callback URL which you have, either you have configured in your MuleSoft flow or you have configured in your Postman flow. I will show you that. Okay, so keep this thing in the mind, this is very important. OAuth, so because like box needs to know where I have to return the authorization code, so that's why we use the callback URL. So let's start. I will copy this folder URL. Okay, the folder URL is a post. Okay, this is folders. And the next thing, I want to set the authorization. I will say OAuth 2, then get new token. The callback URL, I mention you, like we will use the same callback URL which we have configured there. It's very important. Then next thing, account.box authorize URL. The next thing, token URL, the client ID and client secret you can copy from your application. Okay, that's a setting you need to do. Click on request token. First, it will ask for the authentication. You have to provide your username. Okay, you authorize it. Once you authorize, you provide the grant access to box. It will generate the token. The token has been generated. Now, we generate the token. Now we have to pass the JSON message. So I will show you what are the parameters you need to pass. So first, it's a parent. So don't worry. You can see in the specification. You pass ID equal to something 0. Okay. Then comma the name of the folder which you want. I will say test 1 2 3. So this is the message. You can get the specification from this API. So ID, type and name. So type even you can pass as a folder, but I will not pass the type. If you want to pass the type, you can do that. Type equals to folder. Okay, try to send the request. Okay, so it created the folder into the box. Let me verify the folder. It's test 1, 2, 3. Let me refresh it. So you can see the test 1, 2, 3 folder is just created just now today. Okay, by me. You got it? So now how we can integrate with MuleSoft? That's the important thing. So I will say file, new Mule project. So I will say test box application, finish. Now first thing, everybody knows what we will do. We will call the HTTP listener. Let's wait, something gone wrong in console. I have to bring it here. Okay, I am sorry for that. So let's start configuring HTTP listener. Click on this add button. And you can use 808 all default setting. Okay, and slash you can say create. Now next thing, you want to download the box connector. You can go to search in the Exchange and simply say box. So let it search the box. Generally it should not take this much of the time. Let's we search it again. Okay, click on this box, add. Finish. Now I will drag and drop a create folder operation. The box connector provide many operation, so you can make use of any operation, but right now I just want to create a folder. Okay, and apart from that, I will put a transform message in front of this folder. I'll go to HTTP listener. I want to do something in advance. I will change this to post. Okay, and I will create one simple JSON file which contain three or I will say two field. Okay, one is ID. Okay, I will say 0, comma, you know, like name. I can say test 234. Save this JSON file. Desktop, or I will say, you know, test.json. I can change it to all files. Save it. Go to transform message. If you see in the transform message, you can see the metadata has been generated automatically depending on your operation you selected. So right now I selected create, it will generate the metadata. There are a lot of fields, but we will not going to use it. We will use some of the fields. So I will go to transform message and I will define the metadata here. I will say folder JSON. I will say JSON example and I will search for my text test.example.json. Okay, these are the two fields. And as I shown you what are the fields we can map, parent, ID, name, folder is type is not important. So wait, once the metadata is generated, so I can map ID to ID. Even this type will not change, so I can hard code it to folder, but it's not mandatory. And you have to pass the name. Okay, and like you can see name somewhere here. So just map name to name. Okay, this is the mapping. Now important thing, we have to do the create folder. We have to define the configuration for the box. Click on this add button. So first thing, we have to provide client ID and the client secret. Go to your application, copy, paste it here. Go to copy and paste the client secret. So forget about this field. Yeah, this is the important, like local callback config. So what are the HTTP listener? So HTTP listener reference. So we will use the existing HTTP listener reference. So I can copy somewhere from HTTP listener. Yeah, it's this. Okay, I go back to global elements. I can change this name. So like I will change this to OAuth2 callback. So I already show you. So what is the callback URL we have used? What is like it's OAuth2 callback. So I will copy it better. I don't do the mistake. So this is very important URL, local authorization URL. So basically this will enable OAuth dance. So basically, it will initiate OAuth dance where you can generate the authorization code and everything. Now I need to change the callback URL. Make sure this callback URL is match. I'll paste it. Okay. Rest of the thing you can keep as it is. Don't do any changes. Okay. Now I'll go to message flow. I'll start. Save it. Yes. Because there is some other container is running, I ask to stop that. Till that, let me copy the test.json. Edit with Notepad++. I will go to box. Instead of that, I will say post HTTP local host 8081/create. I'm just making the message header body raw JSON, paste it here. Okay, let's wait. Before that, we need to do one step. So application has been deployed. What step? So there is a local authorized URL, right? So basically we need to start the OAuth dance. So we have to copy this URL, and first you log out all the accounts. Let me log out from here also, and let me paste this URL local. So now it will the local, it will redirect me to the box to get authorized. And now grant the access to the box. If you see, it will be redirect me to the localhost 80 callback code CN. So basically this code will be stored somewhere into the application, and it will be this particular application will use this authorization code when it will send a request for token generation. It happens internally, we don't have to do anything. Now the second request, what we have to send, that is the HTTP localhost, the create. Okay, so once you send this request, you can see the folder has been created. We will verify it. So let me log into the box. So let me provide the username and the password. So the important step is that local config authorized URL. Okay, you can see the test folder 234 is created. Let me try with some more folder. So test folder 2341, test folder 2341, send the request. So you can see the test folder 2341 is also will be created. So see test. So why we pass the ID 0? So it's 0. If you see our folder have all folders have ID 0 with, okay. You got it, what we have done, right? So this is how you can make use of MuleSoft to connect the box. I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching it.